Good morning, students. Last class we learned the types of should system. In that we already learned here types of should system: stem, leaves, flower, type parts of the leaves and fruit. Yes, in that also parallel venation and reticulate venation in the leaf. Okay, today I am going to explain types of roots. See here, types of roots. In types of roots we have a three types of roots here: tap root system, fibrous root system and also adventitious root system. One by one I'll explain here. See, types of roots. First, the first part of the plant that grow out of the seed. See, if you have any one seed, assume this is a seed. If it is grow above the parts of the plant that grow out of the seed. If anything grow like this out of the seed, this we have to call the root. If seed also having a in above, if this is a seed means, if above like this out of the seed means, we have to call this is a root here. See, seeds is mostly a root of the plant. As plants grow, so does the root. By their structure, root can be classified into two types: tap root and a fibrous root. The structure and its growing type, we have to consider the two types. These are tap root and a fibrous root system. Sometimes we find the root growing out of some parts of the plant. See here, if one plant already grow, plant or tree already grow here like this, if a root have to root all growing like this means, we have to consider this as the fibrous root system, adventitious root system. These roots are called as the adventitious root system. See, I'll explain further what do you mean by tap root, fibrous root and also adventitious roots. See, at tap root system, in a tap root system, a small root that emerges out of the seed growing into a main root. See, if one main root is like this means, see, from main root it will be grow in a branches. We have to call that is a tap root system. It is called as a primary roots. And the primary root grow a thick and can be store a food. It is a thick. Somewhat it is thick. It holds the food also. And it grows straight and far down into the soil. It is grow far down into the soil. And also there are smaller and thinner roots that grow around the primary roots. Smaller, these are like this, they will grow smaller. Hair-like structures will be grow. And these are called as a secondary or lateral roots. These are called, we have to call, these are the secondary roots or lateral roots. And plants that have a tap root system are primarily fixed and difficult to pull out of the soil. These roots survive to drought the conditions. And plants with the tap root have a reticulate venation in their leaf. See, in their leaf we have a reticulate venations. For example, see carrot. It is a carrot is here. You have it here like this. See, you have like this. You see no carrot, radish, and also chinnar roots and wheat roots. You have it. These are the examples of tap root system. These are the examples of a tap root system. And next, fibrous root system. Fibrous root systems are the root that emerges out of the seed survives briefly. See, this is a like this thick like the, and it will be branched in the thick in the main root system. See, here in fibrous root system, it is a like this. is replaced by bunch of thin roots. Thin roots, but it will be look like a bunch of the thin roots. Only it is a hair-like structures, but it having a bunch of a root system. Unlike the tap root, these do not grow straight and down, but spread out under the soil. It will be not a straight like a for tap root system. Fibrous root system will not a straight. It will be bunch like a hair-like structure, having a bunch like a structure, and they hold a topmost layer of the earth and prevent the soil erosion. It holds the tap root here above the tap root of the soil, and it is control the soil erosion. Soil erosion will be controlled. Fibrous root cannot survive extremely dry condition. It cannot be survived. Andra idu uliyangilla elle dry condition. It will be a dry condition. It can't be survived. And plants with the fibrous roots have a parallel venation in their leaf. I already thought what do you mean by parallel venation. See, leaves can be in parallel venation. Leaves can be like this in paddy and grass. Here you have some examples, wheat, marigold, like this, marigold and grass, these are all examples. Leaf can be parallel venation. Normal leaf like this, no? You have normal leaf, but in parallel venation, leaves can be like this. Paddy, wheat, in that condition, you have to see the fibrous root system. And last, adventitious root system. See, I already taught adventitious root system. After growing the tree, it will be grow from one part of the plant here. The primary root in this type lasts only the short time. Various new roots emerges from either the stem, leaf or other plant part of replace it. These roots act as a storage of food in some plants. For example, sweet potato. These also give the support to hold the food. And in some plants, these roots adapt themselves to give an aerial support in a plant. These are called the prop roots. These will give the aerial support to the plants. These we call as a prop roots. And underground stem usually have adventitious roots. For example, banyan, orchids. Here you have some examples. See, banyan here also, it will having a extra root system. Here also, and cactus plants, these are the examples of adventitious roots. See, here they had given, what do you see in picture, fibrous root system. It is a fibrous, in fibrous root system, you have a thin, and bunch like a structure. This is the taproot system. Taproot system is it will be first one stem like a root, after it will be branched like this in a thick. And prop roots, I already thought of what you mean by prop roots, means it is give the aerial support to the plants. It gives the aerial support to the plants. These are structure will be like this. See, it is gives the aerial support to the plant. Adventitious roots will be like this. See, these are the adventitious roots. Understood, no? Once again, you go through in the textbook and read. See, here, glossary. This is must and should. You have to read and you have to remember this. What do you mean by aerial roots? It will come in one mark questions. And also, see here, aerial roots, a type of a root that grow above the soil. Above the soil, we have to call the aerial roots. Shoot, you know, the part of the plant above the ground which has a stem, leaves and a flower. I already explained what do you mean by shoot. Shoot is having a leaf, stem and also flower, fruit, everything. See, stem, part of the shoot that helps in the taproot water, mineral and prepared food to all parts of the plant. And also xylem, transport water and mineral from root to plant. Xylem means what? Transport water to, here we have a root. Below the ground, we have to call a root system. Above the ground, we have to consider a shoot system. From here to Here it will transport the waters, minerals, chlorophyll, everything, no? That we have to call the xylem. And phloem transport the food and prepared by a leaves to the rest of the plant. See, I already taught here leaves will be a prepared a food using a chlorophyll everything that we have to call the photosynthesis. Yes, these photosynthesis will finish this process. After processing, after finish this process, the xylem, the phloem will be transport food to other parts of the plant. Yes, see, leaf blade. Last class I already explained the broad flat surface of the leaf. We have to call the leaf blade, leaf margin, the line along the edges of the leaf and helps to plant identification. And reticulate venation, the mesh like a pattern of veins inside the leaf, we have to call reticulate venation. Parallel venation, the veins inside the leaf run parallel to each other. And petiole, a tiny stem like a structure that connect a leaf to the stem. Leaf to the stem, we have to call the petiole. And stipule, the thin leaf like a structure at the base of the petiole. The thin leaf like a structure, I already taught here, see. This will be called as this will leaf like a structure. After this seed, after open the flower, it will be holds like a base. We have to call the stipule. And stomata, tiny openings on the leaf that allows the leaves to breathe and give out excess water. And petals, a colorful and modified leaves of the flowers. And sepal, the green leaves that covers the flower bud and are later found at the base of the petals. Carpel, the productive part of the plant, it is the reproductive part of the plant, we have to call the carpel. And stamen, the male part of the plant which has a pollens. And primary roots, the new tiny root that grow out of the seed. I already explained here, this we have to assume, this we have to see means a tiny part of the root will be grow here. We have to call this is primary roots. Tap root, the primary root grow thick and long, has a survival branches. Several branches here, this is the tap root. Lateral roots, the branch of the primary root in the taproot system. Fibrous root, thin and shallow roots that spread out under the soil. Adventitious roots, roots that emerge from any part other than the primary root, mostly from stem and or leaves. Prop roots, adventitious roots that grow earlier and give supports to a aerially and give supports to a large plants. Understood now? I hope you all are understood. Today see, you have to write this glossary and you have to must and should you have to read this and write in your homework book and also turn the page 188 and 189. You have see here parts of the plants. You have explanation also. This we called as a cycle. One cycle here. See, parts of a flower, parts of the leaf, types of roots. You have explanation also. You have to write in your homework book this and you have to write, read it. I will give some questions also. First you have to read and write in your homework book. Understood, no? I hope you all are understood. Once again, you read the lesson and see this video properly, then you will get to know. Thank you.